In this video, I'll talk about how I implemented physics in my Minecraft clone. I have always felt that I was lacking in this area of game dev, but after implementing it for this game, I finally understood it better, and it turned out more satisfying than I expected. And I even made a pig cannon, so let's go! Minecraft doesn't have a perfect physical simulation, but you can do fun stuff with it, so I wanted to do something similar. There are two aspects to this problem: collisions and movement. We will start with collision because they are easier to explain. And then I will explain in depth how forces work. So the approach I take is to store the last position of the entity. In this way, I can easily determine the final movement in that frame, no matter how many times or how I move my entity, just by subtracting the last position from the new one. So now, having this information, I can check if my entity entered the block, and if so, undo its move. Now, just doing this will have a problem, and you will get stuck into walls sometimes. And this is the reason. Look at this diagram. The code will solve the collisions, and it will seem that you are hitting this front block, wrongly placing the player here instead of here. Solving this is easy, fortunately. All you need to do is to apply the movement and solve the collisions for each axis separately. And this works well. Now, the second problem with this approach is what happens if the player moves so fast that it can skip an entire block in a frame. Our current implementation won't solve this. So for now, I use a cheap fix, and that is to check for collisions in multiple increments along the movement line. I might change this in the future to reduce the cost because Minecraft doesn't solve this perfectly to not stall the server, and that seems like a good thing to do. Now, before I talk about forces, don't forget that I will post a poll on my channel, so you can vote on what the next video should be on. For gameplay, you probably noticed that I have already started working at an inventory system, and it's all synchronized with the server and stuff. For the shaders, I will go in depth about how I architectured some harder things like this nice looking water, and trust me, it was not fun to make it be slightly lower than the normal ground. And finally, I added a personality system to the entities, so I want to add some more entities, plus a custom one, so subscribe to not miss out on the vote. Okay, now let's talk about forces. Usually, whenever you make a game, you need to choose if your character movement is controlled using forces or it just moves magically, aka cinematic movement. And by forces, I just mean physical forces that will be simulated by the physics engine in the game. Using forces will make a nicer simulation and a character that is more integrated with the world, but it's way harder to implement a control that doesn't feel slippery and horrible. So I did both. The player is just moved magically when you press your keyboard, but it is also influenced by the surrounding physics. I might switch to fully using forces in the future. Now let's look at how forces are implemented. First of all, we have the position. This is the position of the entity in the world. Next we add a velocity. This is simply added to the player's position times delta time every frame, and this is also clamped to not get out of hand. Whenever a force is applied to the entity, it's added here. I can give an object a constant velocity each frame, and this is how it would look. Okay, now let's simulate something more realistic. First of all, whenever I throw an item, I just apply a force when I throw it, but that's it. This is called an impulse. It's applied only once, and it's not multiplied by delta time. I also added the concept of mass, using the physics equations, but I don't use it yet. We can throw our item again, but it doesn't stop. And that's because there's nothing to slow down that force. For this, we need friction and drag. Friction is a force that slows down objects when they move on the ground, and drag is the same thing, but in air. I applied the drag equation, and you will notice that drag increases with the velocity of the object. I clamped it to not increase too much, so it works better to throw things. And for all coefficients, I didn't use physically correct coefficients, but rather, I just picked values that felt best. Finally, let's add gravity. Gravity is actually an acceleration. So, the acceleration is applied every frame to the velocity, and the velocity is applied every frame to the position of the object. If you throw an object, you will see that it will fall faster with time, so that's what I mean by acceleration. Please don't hurt anyone with throwing objects. So, I just apply gravity each frame, and I also clamp the acceleration, and I also reset it to zero at the end of the frame. The idea is that you have to keep applying the acceleration to accelerate. With all of this in place, here is the result. Now, I also made friction with blocks, and different blocks have different frictions, and there is even friction on walls. And you can control it, so for example, you don't really want the player to have friction with walls because that will just make it annoying to jump over them. Now, it's really fun to play with this, and I will definitely be using forces later, and maybe add some kind of boots to make the player slippery, because this is very fun. Finally, let's make a pig cannon. But first, I will mention that I learned these physics things from this video, and if you want more cool programming resources, you can find this video and many others in my Discord server in the resources channel. Now, to implement the pig cannon, I first need to implement entities pushing on each other. So for each entity, I just look at the entities that are in the neighboring chunks and check if they collide. And if so, I just apply a force to that entity. And this very simple mechanism seems to work very well. And with my compile time entity component system, I also made it very easy to integrate. You inherit from this if you want to push others. And if you want others to push you, you just use this code. Now, my entities have an axis aligned collider, and I also use the same collider to push other entities. The idea for the cow cannon in Minecraft was that their collider was popping slightly outside the blocks, and if you put enough cows, they can push you very far, but I won't give out so easily. So I increased the collider size of the pigs to see how it would look. Well, that was very cool, but with my vanilla physics, you can still do a pig dispenser. You'll also notice that entities push themselves up. That was by design, and I think it's a little more realistic. Thanks to the channel members for helping me. So, don't forget about the voting. And if you want to see videos faster, share this video with others, because if I make more views, I upload more often. See you!